Are you currently suffering from hip pain, but confused on what is actually causing it? If so, this is the video for you. Hey everyone, my name is Dr. Zach Greenwood here at Performance Sport and Spine in Seattle, Washington. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how you can accurately and concisely figure out whether hip pain is being caused by hip arthritis, hip impingement, or gluteal tendinitis tendinopathy. The hip joint is a ball and socket, and it's comprised of two bones, the thigh or femur, and the socket of acetabulum of the pelvis. And it's a crucial joint to provide mobility and stability from the lower limb to the pelvis in such activities as walking, running, or jumping. How this video is gonna work is we're gonna go over each condition separately, showing how it commonly presents, the most important criteria, and the relevant test. After you figure out which one you have, you're gonna click in your upper right on a video card that's gonna take you to another video to show you the best exercises and ways to manage this on your own. First, we're gonna cover hip osteoarthritis. This is where functional and structural changes to the hip joint itself. This is the most common condition affecting the hip, and it's estimated that 240 million people worldwide have this condition, and it's much more prevalent in people over the age of 50 years old. How this condition commonly presents is pain or stiffness in the groin or buttock region. The symptoms are worse first thing in the morning and usually get better as you move around, and rest often improves this condition. The four major signs for this condition are loss of range of motion, especially in rotation or abduction, difficulty putting on shoes or socks, difficulty getting in and out of the car, or having a hard time sitting on the floor with your legs crossed. Imaging can be helpful for diagnosis, specifically x-rays and MRI, but make sure that these imaging findings also correlate with your clinical findings. There are three forms of this: mild, moderate, and severe. So if someone tells you you have hip OA, make sure they tell you which severity you have. The best orthopedic test for this is the Fader test, where we're pushing the ball into the socket. Now this test is much more powerful when it's negative. If there's no pain during this test, you can be very confident that you don't have hip OA. If it's positive, it tells you that something's wrong, but not what exactly is wrong. If these symptoms sound like the thing that you're suffering from, click on that card on your upper right screen to figure out how to manage it and do the best exercises. Second is hip impingement. Now this again is caused by the hip joint and bony changes. Now there's cam changes, which is to the head of the femur, or pincher changes, which is to the socket of the pelvis. These bony changes often happen in your teenage years, especially with athletes, as the increase in stress and load on the joint causes the bones to get larger. But often people don't have symptoms until their 20s or 30s. How this presents as groin or hip pain, and half the time both hips will be affected, and half the time you'll also have buttock pain. For diagnosing this, we need three things: symptoms, positive test, and then findings on x-ray or MRI. So the symptoms would be reduced range of motion of the hip, clicking, catching, or locking, and it's usually worse with things like squats or lunges. There should be positive findings for orthopedic tests as Fader and Faber, and there should be relevant bony changes on x-ray or MRI. If these symptoms of hip impingement sound like what you're suffering with, click on the video card right here in your upper right to start managing it on your own. Unlike the first two, that were the hip joint itself, gluteal tendinitis or tendinopathy is actually the gluteal tendon that runs on the outside of the hip. This condition is more common in females than males, especially postmenopausal, and it makes up about 10% of all hip pain. It's also the most common form of tendinopathy. How this commonly presents is lateral hip pain, or pain on the outside of the hip, but it may radiate down the thigh or into the front of the groin. The pain is worse with adduction movements, or moving your leg across midline, or single leg loading. There's tenderness over the greater trochanter. Walking is painful, and it hurts to sit cross-legged or laying on the affected side. The best test is a single leg stance, the Faber test, and then testing for lateral hip strength. Two more important things about this condition are a wider pelvis, and then medications such as fluoroquinolones can be risk factors for it. Now, if these symptoms seem familiar with what you're experiencing, click the video card in the upper right corner to start managing it on your own. We covered a lot in this video, so we're gonna give you a nice concise summary in case you wanna refresh or go over stuff again. For hip OA, hip or groin pain over the age of 50, the pain or stiffness is worse in the morning and gets better after 30 minutes. It's better with rest, and there's a loss of range of motion. Hip impingement, groin pain, where half the time it's symmetrical and half the time there's buttock pain, often presents between 20 and 30 years old and the person often plays sports in the past. This is worse with movements such as squatting and lunging, and the person may have catching, locking, or pinching feeling of the hip. Gluteal tendinitis or tendinopathy. It's more common in females than males. The pain is on the lateral outside of the hip. The pain is often worse with walking or single leg exercises. There's tenderness over the greater trochanter, and sitting or laying on the affected side is often painful. After 10 years of being in clinical practice, I was able to come up with this video in a simple and straightforward way that helps separate all the noise from the clinical relevant stuff in a way that's very easily digestible. Thank you for watching our video on these issues. We hope you found it helpful. If you did, please like the video and subscribe to our channel, and then don't forget to check out our other videos.